What's up, Antioquian Village, and welcome back. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to build a fire. Get ready. One of the first things you do if you want to build a campfire is to find a good spot for it. Now, make sure you find a spot that's far away from trees or other things. That way, nothing else catches on fire. For example, this bonfire pit is far from any trees and other things. That way, nothing else can catch on fire. Also, if you don't already have a bonfire pit or something surrounding where the fire will go, it's a good idea to build a circle of rocks. That way your fire can stay contained inside your fire pit. Next, we need to gather materials to build the fire. The first thing I'm going to grab is a lighter, especially one with a long end. That way I can reach it under the fire to light it. But first, I'm going to check with my mom to make sure it's okay to use. Hey mom, can I use the lighter to make a campfire?
Thanks for asking, as long as you're safe, yes.
Thanks mom. The second thing we'll find is something that will light on fire. And here's some old newspaper that we're gonna recycle. This is perfect. Along with the newspaper, I'm also gonna bring some dryer lint that I collected. All right, now that I have a lighter and something to catch on fire, I need to get some wood. Are you guys ready? What? You don't like my shoes? What's wrong with Crocs? Oh, you're right. I'm about to go in the woods. I'm not wearing the right attire. This calls for a quick change. Perfect. Boots and tall socks. Now I'm almost ready for a hike, but I think I could use a better shirt. Maybe one that is about a hike. Awesome, a hike shirt. Hike 2015? All right, not gonna lie, this is a little tight. I think I've grown a bit. We can do better. Awesome, a hike shirt from 2019? Much better. This'll work great. Now that we're all dressed and ready to get some firewood, we're headed into the woods. So I've got a bag for some firewood, and also I brought a speaker because I love to jam out. So one of the things we're looking for when we're looking for wood is kindling. So here we found some stuff that is gonna be really great for kindling. It's really dry and really thin, so I'm gonna collect that and put it in the bag. Something else that's really important when you're finding firewood is that it's dry. This I found right here is really dry, and this will be perfect for some medium to small size logs. And now we've got our wood, and it's time to go out of the woods. Now that we have firewood and all our materials, we're gonna start making a fire. So, first, I'm gonna take some of whatever we're using to light on fire and put that in the middle. I have some dryer lint and I have some newspaper as well. I'm gonna use a little of both. And then I'm gonna take my kindling, which is our really small dry sticks, and I'm gonna put that all around it. For now, I'm gonna start with making sort of a teepee formation with the kindling around the lint and newspaper. Now that there is a teepee with some dryer lint and newspaper inside, we're gonna light it and be ready to give it oxygen and extra wood if it starts to light. When I fan, it's just to get some extra oxygen to the fire, and you don't want to do that too much, but enough to keep the fire alive. Now that some of it's burning, we have to be ready to add extra wood because the small kindling burns out fast because it's so small. We're still adding some small wood. We don't want to add anything too big too quick because those take longer to catch on fire. Now that we've got a good sized fire going and our small logs are starting to light, we can start adding some more medium sized logs.
Now, don't get discouraged if you can't light a fire the first time you try. Often, it takes a few tries of lighting your newspaper or dryer lint before the kindling lights and you get a big campfire.
As I add more medium-sized logs, I'm still giving the fire lots of air. Now I can start to add bigger logs.
As I add bigger logs, I still try to keep the teepee formation where each of the logs meet in the middle above the center of the campfire.
So as the fire grows, just keep adding wood and bigger, and then you have yourself a fire. The fire we did was more of a teepee shape where all the logs kind of like meet in the middle. You can also do a kind of fire that's popular where you make a sort of square around the fire with logs and sort of like Lincoln logs where you kind of line up wood on top of each other in a square. That works too. Now that we have a bonfire, there's tons of things you can do to have some fun. And for me, one of my favorite things to do is play the guitar and sing campfire songs with my friends. Billy, what do you think about that? I was thinking the same thing. I love singing Taylor Swift songs at the campfire. Now that we've got a fire, I've got one more shirt change to do. Here we go. Oh, perfect. Wanna know why? The fire, it's lit. I hope you guys learned a little bit today about how to make a campfire. And remember, to be safe, always around the fire. Have fun and don't eat too many s'mores. Well, I realized I can't tell you all that my favorite thing to do at a campfire is sing campfire songs without singing one. So, I'm a mediocre guitar player and singer at best, but here we go. Typical overnight, I only took 100 tries to get the car to light, but we never give up like Judas, cause we wear long socks with our high t-shirts, we sleep in tents and we eat too many s'mores, dreaming about the day when we wake up in tents next to our cabin mates, cause that's on the overnight. It's our favorite night of the whole session. Even if it rains, we know we'll be okay, cause rain builds character. Even though it's often a challenge, it makes us that much stronger as a captain, because I've got your back on the overnight. Thanks for listening in, and hope to see you soon. The first thing I'm gonna grab is a lighter, especially one with a long, what is this? What even is that? Nice. Boots and tall socks. Now I'm ready. Perfect. So I'm going to bring this back too for some medium-sized trees. Not trees. Medium-sized logs. No, not that.
Turn around and find
I am lost in the wood. Ooh, that was kind of good. You recording that?
No way. We've got a rare creature over here. I haven't seen one of these in ages. Come get a closer look. It's right down here in the leaves.
Now don't get too close. These things like to jump. No, it's a little bit lower, lower, lower.
Watch out!
Just kidding.